We are at the Legislative Yuan today, where the legislature convened once again 11 days after the initial clash between the opposition Kuomintang and the Taiwan People's Party and the ruling Democratic Progressive Party. Today, the opposition parties aim to advance the third reading of the controversial parliamentary reform bills.
2024年5月28号 将是台湾民主史上非常重要的一天。 推动了30年的国会改革， 建立听证调查制度， 强化人事同意权的审查。 我们希望在5月28号的这一天 能够顺利地完成三读。
今天是中华民国在写历史， 为2300万人共同来见证。 在21世纪的今天， 中华民国终于走上民主潮流的国家的一员。
The proposals that passed the second reading last week include requiring the president to answer questions from legislators after his State of the Nation address. The proposals also require a contempt of Congress regulations bill, recorded votes for appointing or overseeing personnel assignments, and granting the legislative yuan the right to investigation and hearings.
我们也认为要退回委员会审议，因为这一个委员会几乎都没有讨论的空间，然后到大会这边也没有让我们发言，只是一条，只是三分钟，一个人，其他就通通要求我们停止讨论。此时此刻，扩权法案还在审议当中，民进党的职责是全力的诉求，我们希望阻却它完成二三读，这还是我们最终的努力。So,
what would happen if the third reading passed? If the legislature approves the reforms, the executive yuan can decide whether to send them back to the legislature for a second review upon receiving the bills. If they wish to do so, the executive yuan must act within 10 days with the approval of the president. Legislators opposing the bills could also seek a constitutional interpretation or submit a referendum proposal. But a minimum of 29 legislators, a quarter of the legislature, is required to advance the request. But what happens if the third reading is not passed?
我们立院党团多次已经说了这一部违宪扩权的扩权法案，我们一定会在二三读之后，我们事实上也已经在筹备事先的相关作业、相关准备。一个人民的监督越严厉，
就是伟大国家的象征，这一点我们请任何一个执政党都要了解，能够让立法权跟行政权互相的监督制衡，这才是成熟民主国家应该有的展现。
If the bills are not passed, the process will be halted until after the new premier, Zhuo Rongtai, addresses the legislature on Friday, May 31st, with the current legislative session extended to July 16th. Zhuo has expressed a desire for the executive and the legislative yuan to reach a peaceful consensus and has asked protesters to refrain from gathering as an extension of goodwill. However, these remarks have been criticized, with some interpreting them as a blunt deterrence of the growing Bluebird movement. As supporters and protesters gather today, everyone will be watching with bated breath as the legislators take vote. This is Vivian Hsiao for TVBS World Taiwan.